Hello loves, welcome back to my channel. Here's my everyday natural glow routine look. If you guys want to know how I achieve this look, please continue watching. So first I'm going to start off by parting my hair into four sections. This wig, just a disclaimer, is my I don't care or whatever wig. So it's not the best, but it does get the job done and it's still cute. So yeah, so I'm just going to add a few curls here and there, and they're going to be going towards my face or away from my face. And I'm doing this all over my head throughout the sections until I can get my desired look. And so just moving up to the top sections, I'm just still curling the hair away from my face. So this is how this side looks. I'm just brushing it and combing it until I get it to how I want to look. And then I'm going to repeat the same steps to the other side. So this is how it's looking. I'm just going in and tweaking a little bit more areas wherever I feel like needs more volume, and just, you know, fluffing it around until I get it to my liking. Okay, so here's how the back is looking. Just something cute and simple and ready to go. So now moving on, I'm going to start off by pinning my hair up. And then I'm going to start off by priming and moisturizing my face. This is a moisturizer from Supreme Premier. And then the primer is from Pore Professionals. Priming and moisturizing your face is a must when doing makeup. It just allows a flawless base, a flawless finish. And then I'm going to go on with this e.l.f. Cosmetics Highlight and Contour Cream Palette. And I'm going to use that yellow and medium brown shade to cover up a few acne marks. This step is not mandatory. It is optional. I don't even do this step all the time, but for the sake of the video, I did do it. And so now I'm going to go in with this L'Oreal Infallible Matte Foundation, and I am in the shade 109, and I'm going to use the Silicone Beauty Blender to blend out that product on my face. Silicone Beauty Blenders are like a new wave right now, and I really love them over a beauty blender just because it doesn't take away the product that you use. It's more so showing you how much you're wasting, and it does blend it out like a lot more seamless than I feel a beauty blender does. So now I'm going to go in with this Anastasia Beverly Hills Highlighter, and I'm going to use the shade 3.5, and I'm going to highlight my face. I highlight underneath my eye, my cupid's bow, my chin, my nose, and my forehead as so. And then I'm going to go back in with that e.l.f. Cosmetics palette, and I'm going to use that yellow and medium brown shade again, and I'm literally just going to place that right on top of my highlight. You do not have to do this step. I just do it because I like an extra highlight, but to each his own. You do not have to do this step. And I do also highlight underneath my cheekbone area just to get my contour a more defined look. And you'll see that later in the video. So now I'm going to go back in with that e.l.f. Cosmetics contour palette. And I'm going to contour my cheekbones, my forehead, and my jawline area. And I'm also going to grab a smaller brush and contour my nose, my cupid's bow, and underneath my lip. I did not apply this just like perfectly. I kind of slapped it on there. However, if you can blend, you're okay. And you're just going to blend it out. Really, blending will save you from any mess ups that you make. So yeah. So here, I apply way too much contour to my nose, but that is okay. Like I said, as long as you can blend, you will be all right, okay? You will not necessarily mess up. So I'm just going to blend it all out, and it'll be okay later. And I'm just going back in with that brush that I applied the contour with to start off with the blending of it, and I'm just blending out my contour all over my face. And then I'm going to go back in here in just a second with the beauty blender and blend out the rest of my highlight. The time is now. That's why I highlight underneath my cheekbone area, just so it gives it, like, that defined line. And then I highlight my lip and my cupid's bow, because my cupid's bow isn't really defined. So I do it to define my cupid's bow, but also I like highlighting my lip because it makes it a little bit more plumper when I go to outline my lip and apply my lip color. So here, that's all I'm doing, just defining that area. And you will see me take a little bit of the extra product that I use on my nose and just deepening up my cupid's bow area more. And I'm just going to blend out the rest of that highlight and move on to the next step. So I'm just going to keep blending a little bit more. And really, you're just going to blend it all out until you get it to exactly how you want it to look. And I did go back and add a little bit more contour, just where I feel like my contour got kind of faded or washed out at. But that's pretty much it, just blending and going back in with stuff. With a little bit more product, I mean. Like so. Y'all see how it looks just like my skin still? Bomb. So now I'm going to go in with this Bobbi Brown highlighter stick, and I'm going to highlight my cheekbone area, the tip of my nose, my cupid's bow, my upper lip, and also my forehead. This is going to help create that like glow dewy look. So that's how I'll achieve that here. And I'm just going to use that beauty blender and blend out the highlight. So now I'm going to go in with this BH Cosmetics Highlight and Contour Powder Set. And I'm going to take those bottom three colors to set my contour. And that's all I'm doing here. And then I'll use a smaller brush to contour my nose with it. But I'm using those same three colors. And then I'm just going to use this fluffy brush and further blend out my contour and highlight, making sure everything is together before we set underneath the eyes. So now with setting our highlight, I used a whole bunch of powders in my little mix concoction. So I'll have all of the powders that I use in my description box. But also, I don't like setting my face. I literally will press it into my skin. And then I wipe off the excess with a brush. I just don't prefer that step. However, you can do it. It's just not something I like to do. And I do also cut my contour so it's a little bit more defined. So that's why I set some powder underneath there as well. And then I'm going to go back in with that BH Cosmetics kit. And I'm going to use that yellow in the peachy shade just so I can wipe off all of the residue from the powder, the excess powder. And so now I'm going to go on with this e.l.f. Cosmetics highlighter. This highlighter was $4, and it's literally my favorite highlighter right now. And I'm just highlighting my cupid's bow, my lip, the bridge of my nose, my forehead, and my cheekbones. And I also highlight a little bit above my brow bone area. I mean, not my brow bone area, just above my brow. And that's what I'm doing here. You can kind of see it a little bit. So this is really helping to get that natural glowy look. And I'm just going to blend it out a little bit more. And then I'm going to go in with this Eye Pooey Moisture Mist from Paul Mitchell. And I'm going to use it to set my face. It's basically just hydrated water. And then I'm going to highlight my collarbone area to even make it a little bit more glowy. And then I'm going to go in with this Wet n Wild eyeliner pencil in a shade brown. And I'm just using it as a lip liner. And then I'm going to take this, I think it's from CoverGirl. It's like a holographic lip gloss. I'm not using a lip gloss, more so just a wand to blend out that lip liner. And then I'm going to go in with MAC Cosmetics lipstick in the shade Naturally Transformed. And this will be my lip color for the day. And I'm just using my lips to blend the product around. And then moving on to my brows, I'm just going to brush them in place. Now, before I actually apply the product, I like to carve them or just outline them first with product just to save a step. And then I go in and I fill them in. So that's all I'm doing here. And I'm going to do the same to the other side. And I'm going to use the Anastasia Dip Brow in the shade Dark Chocolate to fill in my brows. And I just start by outlining just how I did with the concealer. And then I'm going to fill it in and then outline the top line of my brow. I do leave the beginning free of a product just because I like to brush it up, and then I also like create like hair like strokes, so it kind of creates an ombre effect or a fade effect, so it's not too harsh, like so. And then I just repeated the same step to the other side, and I'm using this brush to blend out the highlight that I placed underneath. And then I'm going to go right back in with that e.l.f. Cosmetics highlighter, and I'm going to highlight my brow bone area. I did off camera add my moles back into my skin and also added mascara underneath my eye. But this is the end result, you guys. If you guys like to see more videos like this, just let me know in the comments. And please don't forget to subscribe to my channel, guys. But yeah, thanks for watching. See you soon.